way to the Girl Cave. I'm Kiera.
I'm Justice.
Kiera and Kai. Do you remember that?
Oh.
Kai.
We're not Kiera and Kai today, though, because we're not drinking.
No, yeah, Pat.
So, Kiera and Justice.
Welcome back, guys. It's been a while. God.
So happy to be filming for you guys. I'm literally excited. If you can't tell.
We back. Or whatever. And this week we have some fun topics with just, what do we call this, OG girl talk?
Yes, dude.
We have some fun topics for just us two.
Some OG-ish.
So let's just go ahead and get right into it.
Okay, so I was on Instagram and I saw this caption or whatever, and I'll just read it, okay? So she posted a picture of her husband. And she said, most women want a man that's already established. A strong woman will be a part of his struggle, survive it, succeed together, and build an empire. Do you agree?
I do agree. But I feel like with that statement, I feel like it's more so on the guy that be like, they always like, oh, I'm not ready. Or, I'm not financially stable to have a girl right now.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, it's kind of like falling on them as to why sometimes we're not together, you know? Because, like, they just be like, oh, I'm not ready yet. Like, what does that mean?
But let's be real, because having a girlfriend is an expense, and it can definitely be an expense depending on the type of girl that you have or the type of things that you want to be able to provide for your girl. Now, granted.
Okay, go ahead.
Some guys could use it as an excuse, like, right. I'm not ready, like, you know, like, just because they're not feeling you or they don't want, you know, like, they're not set on you or whatever, they can use it as an excuse, but I do feel like, I've seen different situations where it has been the guy saying, you know, he's not ready for a relationship, and then I also agree that I want to be in a relationship where I built with my guy. I don't want a guy that's already established.
Exactly. I feel like, because I'm not established.
Right.
So I'm like, if we can work on ourselves together and, like, we can brainstorm together on how to build a better life for each other, then right. I feel like it'll make it a little bit more stronger. Like, I would say that I don't want a guy that's already established, but I would appreciate the fact that he wouldn't use that as an excuse not to actually pursue anything with me, because he's actually looking forward to actually building something with me.
I definitely agree. I definitely, because that's the situation. So Kiera and I both agree with the statement that was stated. But I have seen a situation where, you know, a guy just had different priorities. He either had kids.
Yeah.
And he had to put his finance in different places. And he wasn't able to, I'm not going to say he wasn't able to, but honestly, it could be a coward way out, though. Because, like, if you're going through some things, your girl can be understanding and be there with you while you're struggling and trying to help you put your finances where in order and where they should
be. That's why you said it also depends on the girl, too. Because sometimes, like, a real woman would be like, it's fine. Like, some women, they take the check, you know?
Yeah.
Like, they can, like, she can get you groceries. Y'all can eat in all the time. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not, I just look at it as an excuse.
A cop-out.
Yeah.
Like, this shit is getting hard, situations are getting tough and I can't handle it.
Yeah.
Type shit.
But sometimes, I mean, there's been situations where, like, I've respected when the individual said it because I knew that it was coming from a genuine place.
Right. Yeah.
Like, he only wanted to make sure that when he's coming to me, that he's going to be able to give his all.
Yeah.
And, like, maybe he was just not able to give his all at that moment. So I respect it when it's coming from a genuine place, but when it's, like, an excuse to just be buddies or just be booty calls or whatever,
yeah,
that's when I just be like, okay,
yeah. That's some bullshit.
Period. Because this is a scenario that I was telling you earlier.
Yeah.
So there was this guy, and I basically reached out to him, and I was like, I'm trying to start talking to you, blase, blase. Mind you, before all of this, we were, like, on some, like, tit-for-tat type shit, like, oh, I want to talk to you, oh, it's not the right time, oh, I want to talk to you, it's like that.
Yeah.
So I reached out to him, basically shooting my shot, like, oh, I want to, like, I want to talk to you. What you trying to do? And he basically, he was like, straight up, he was like, I'm not ready for a relationship right now. Like, I'm not ready for anything like that right now because I got a lot going on. And I was like, I respect it. And from the, like, from that time to now, it's literally been just him growing and, like, bettering himself. Mm-hmm. So I respect it. Mm-hmm. So that's just, like, a scenario.
Has he ever tried to, like, have y'all ever tried to, like, reach back out to each other and, like, rekindle? Mm-hmm. How is it? Like, he's still feeling like he's not ready or, like?
When it got to that point, he was on some, like, okay, I'm ready now. What you trying to do? But that was just then. Yeah. Nothing transpired after that.
Yeah.
So it was like, I feel like once that conversation is had, there has to be some type of action afterwards.
Definitely. Especially. Have you ever seen, like, I've been seeing stuff on, like, Twitter where, like, a guy or a girl will tell the other person, like, oh, well, I'm not ready for a relationship yet, and then they'll pop out on Instagram with their boo, like, the next week. That could definitely be a situation if a guy.
Yeah, it could be. I don't know. I feel like at the age that we're at, the only way that a guy is really like on some, I'm trying to better myself, I'm not ready for a relationship right now, if he's really like mentally and physically in his career, like really trying to groundbreak his career. That's the only other reason. Because I feel like guys our age, they have some type of finances to be able to provide for.
At this point. And baby, a relationship is supposed to make you better. It's supposed to better you. You guys are supposed to help each other grow.
That's what I want. Energy. We can struggle together. We can struggle together. Like, right. Sometimes women need, like, that positive energy. Like, I know with me, like, I'm single. And sometimes I, like, I come to y'all all the time. Like, all my friends are always good to my friends and confide in them all the time. And it's always, like, the same response. But it's, like, sometimes I'll just be, like, oh, I wish I actually had somebody.
Right.
Like, a guy that's, right, like, going through, right, the same, right, situation, right, that I'm going through, that I can, right, reach out to.
Right.
And we can uplift each other, you, right, know?
He can, like, be your comfort.
Right. And just be, like, baby, it's going to be okay.
Right. Just rub my back.
Just rub my back.
Just let me cry on your shoulder.
Gonna be okay.
Let me be dramatic to you.
Babe, I heard you. We gonna be okay. But no, for real. So why do you think that guys are like that? Why do you think guys actually use that? Well, the guys that use it as an excuse.
Like, because they're not interested, or maybe they really are just in that selfish stage where they're just like, I just want to focus on myself. Which isn't really a selfish thing, because that's important. Focusing on yourself, making sure you have your stuff together is important.
And that's
important.
A respectful excuse as long as you say that. Like, yeah. I just want to focus on myself right now.
Yeah. Like, you can't do nothing but respect that.
Right. Like you really can't. Like, I feel like I respect that even more, the fact that you can actually tell me the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of, like, beat around the bush and,
or
like,
try to lead me on.
Try to protect my feelings.
Right.
Like, don't protect my feelings. Just,
right,
keep it real.
Or try to lead me on and do, like, that's lame. Like, no, just keep it real.
Just keep it real.
If you're not interested, just say that, because you're wasting our time, baby. You got me believing, having false hope.
Yeah, facts. So, like, what about the ones that, like, respectfully say, okay, I'm not ready for something right now. They're actually living by that. What do you think it is with them? Do you think that it's a financial thing and it's like a pride thing to where they feel like they're not going to be able to?
It's no telling, honestly. It could be a financial thing, or it could be because maybe they have, like I said, have
kids. Yeah.
Or maybe because you just never know the struggles that people are going through.
Yeah, I feel like it's definitely like a financial pride type thing, because men, like, they automatically have that intuition of wanting to provide, mm-hmm, you know?
Be the provider.
Right, and when they know that, like, they're not capable of doing that,
right,
they probably be like, okay,
it makes them feel like less than.
Less than, exactly, and that's not something that they want to feel.
At all. Guys hate feeling that way.
Yeah.
I mean, which is understandable, I guess.
I mean, yeah, that's understandable.
Well, let us know if you guys agree with that statement or how you feel. Because a lot of women, like most women in Atlanta, they already want a baller, baby.
No, yeah. They want you already paid, okay? Because she wants you to pay her.
Period.
get. Like, poo, pay me. That's what they want. That's not all women, though. That's what y'all need to get out your heads. That's not all women.
Yeah, you gotta find you a good one. So,
we out
on both aspects. Find you a good girl, find you a good guy. Connect, build.
We out here, baby.
That's what I feel like it's about. But you could also build with the guy that's already established, but you're not. I don't know, y'all.
I think you can. I feel like you can definitely build with a guy that's already established, as long as he don't, like, take the fact or use the fact that you're not already established against you.
No, as long as he's not throwing it in your face, right? Like, I do this for you, I do that for you. Right,
exactly. Like, he can't use that against you. As long as he's, like, respectfully respecting you, respecting your grind, what you're going through, then, yeah, that can definitely work out. But those are rare.
Right.
Those are rare.
Because guys love the whole shit over your head. Yeah. People in general, I guess, sometimes. Even women, too. So.
We just gotta let go, guys.
Gotta flow.
We just gotta flow, just, you know?
OMG!
This is my flowing.
We're flowing. The big flowing couch.
Thank you guys so much for watching part one with us. Make sure that you comment below. Let us know how you feel about this topic. And if you agree with the things that we were stating, if you don't, let us know as well. If you've even been in a situation like this, just tell us. Oh, a man can tell us too. What if a woman was like, what if it was like swapped and a woman was like, I'm not
ready.
What would be our excuse for saying that we're not ready?
I'm pregnant.
I'm pregnant. That's why I'm not ready.
I'm
pregnant. That's real though.
No bad. I'm not ready yet.
Because I can't think of no other excuse.
I'm not financially ready. That's not a good one.
That's really not an excuse at all. It's definitely
like, or she could just be like, I'm focusing on myself.
Focusing on herself. Like, yeah, self-care.
Self-care.
A lot of women are really on like the self-care, channeling their energy. Mindset right now. So yeah, that will be our excuse. Comment below if you guys feel that we're correct, or if you have any other changes that you think that we should make to our opinion.
Be sure to catch us in part two and follow all our Instagram accounts after this.